KSS GSA paper 2016 and it's question number 11, part A. Part A is question number 11. A distribution company provides household to departmental stores. There is a distribution company, and this distribution company is providing household items to departmental stores. And it provides within a range of 50 kilometers radius. Okay. So this is the basically distribution. Distribution from the godown of the company. Now there are three stores. Now these are the number of stores. So we have three stores that are basically within 10 kilometer or less. Suppose I want to draw it. Suppose this is the company's godown. And this is the radius of 10 km, then you have the radius of 20 km, then 30 km, then 40 and then 50. So these three stores, they are located within 10 km. Suppose this is 10 km or less than 10 km, maybe 1 km, maybe, but less than 10 km or up to 10 km. Then there are 15 stores that basically lie within 11 to 20 km. So suppose from 10 to 20, so within this area you have how many stores? 15. Then 26 stores are from 21 km to 30 km from the company's godown. So from company's godown, this was 10 km, this was 20 km, and from 20 to 30. This is 20, this is 30. You have how many stores? 26. From 21 to 30 km. Then number of stores are 20, and these 20 stores are 31 km to 40 km from company's godown. And 16 stores are 41 km to 50 km from company's godown. So this was the basically distribution. Now part one is how many stores does the distribution company serve? These are number of stores. If you can count all of them, they will add up to 80. 3 plus 15 plus 26 plus 20 plus 16 is 80. So company is basically serving 80 stores. This was answer for part 1. For part 2, what is the most common? I am repeating, most common distance of stores from company's godown. Now, number of stores basically represents frequency. If you will observe, the highest number of stores are 26. So against 26, you have a distance of 21 to 30 km. So this distance is the most common distance whose frequency is largest. So your answer will be 26, because its frequency is largest among all of the others, and your answer will be this distance, 21 to 30. Basically, they have asked your distance, so your answer should be 21 to 30. So I am writing here 21 to 30 kilometers. This is most common distance. So part number 3 is how many stores are 35 kilometers or more from godown. Now for this part, you need to draw a histogram. They have asked us to tell how many stores are 35 km or more from godown. If you will see this table, you can find number of stores that are from more than 10 km. All these are more than 10 km. Then all these are more than 20 km. Then all these below are more than 30 km. Then from here, these stores which are below from here are more than 40 km. But they haven't told us directly that how many stores are 35 kilometer or more, we have a range from 31 to 40. Now, I know that from 41 to 50 we have 16 stores, but what about 35? 35 falls in this group. And I don't know how many stores are 35 to 40. Because 20 are given, 20 are for 31 to 40 kilometer. These 20 stores fall between 31 to 40 kilometer. No, I can say that 16 stores are at 38 kilometer, or one store is at 32 kilometer. So I don't know the exact distribution. So for this part, you need to draw a histogram. For the histogram, basically, you need to draw class boundary, frequency, and frequency density. No. Why there is a need of drawing class boundary? If you will observe, this distance is 10 km or less. No, less means it may be 1 km or 0 km. So from 0 to 10, we have 3 stores. So in the first column, I have written 0.5 to 10.5. No, basically the concept of boundary comes here. Why? Histogram is plotted when bars are adjacent to each other, they are not separate. So if you will observe, your first row is up to 10 km and your second row starts from 11 km. It ends at 20 km. The next starts from 21. So there is a gap. 20 and 21, there is a gap. In histogram, we don't need a gap because histograms are continuous. So you have to basically adjust this gap, and for adjusting this gap, you need to draw class boundaries. Now for the first case, I am considering here, this is 10 km, so I am considering here, suppose it is 1 to 10 km. This one. From 1 to 10 km, you have 3 stores. Now what is the concept of class boundary? From 1 to 10, you need to subtract 0.5 from lower value, it will become 0.5, and you need to add 0.5 in the upper value of your class, that will become 10.5. Do the same process for rest of the classes. This is 11. Subtract 0.5 from the lower value of your class, it will become 10.5. And in the upper value, add 0.5, it will become 20.5. Now in the next class, subtract 0.5 from the lower value, 21 minus 0.5, 20.5. Now add 0.5 in the upper value of this class, it will become 30.5. Now come to the next class, subtract 0.5 from the lower value, it will become 30.5. Add 0.5 with upper value, it will become 40.5. Similarly, repeat it for the last class too. Subtract 0.5 from 41. This is lower value of this class, it will become 40.5. And add 0.5 with upper value of this class, it will become 50.5. Now, after this, what you have observed? This is 10.5. This first class is ending this, in this case at 10.5, and the next class is starting from 10.5, ending at 20.5, next starting from 20.5, ending at 30.5, next starting from 30.5, now the letter is continuous. Now draw a histogram. On the x-axis, you will be drawing class boundary. And on the y-axis, you will plot frequency density. I am denoting it with F dot D. Frequency density. Now what is frequency density? For this class, up 10 km, your frequency was 3. 3. Now what is frequency density? Frequency density is basically frequency, which is 3, divided by the class width, and in this case width is 10. 10.5 minus 0.5 is 10. So frequency f divided by class width, CW. divided by 10, your answer is 0.3. Now come to the second class, 10.5 to 20.5. We have been pointing that here that from 11 to 20 kilometer we have 15 stores. So your frequency is 15. Frequency density is frequency divided by the width of your class, and width is again 10. 20.5 minus 10.5 is 10. So frequency divided by class width, which is 10, your answer is 1.5. Similarly, for the next class, find frequency density, frequency over class width, and width is again 10. The difference between the upper class value, upper class limit and lower class limit, or upper class boundary and lower class boundary is 10. So frequency divided by the difference, 26 over 10 is 2.6. For the next class, frequency is 20, and the difference in the class boundaries are 10, 20 over 10 is 2. Similarly, you will come to the last one, so this is frequency density. Now, I will plot frequency density on the y-axis and class boundaries on the x-axis. Now, from 0.5 to 10.5, my frequency density is 0.3. From 0.5 to 10.5, my frequency density, which is on the y-axis, is 0.3, as you can see. So your bar will go up to 0.3 and it will close at 10.5. So the next bar will start from 10.5 and at 20.5, and its frequency density is 1.5. Bar starts at 10.5, it will go up to height of 1.5, as you can see, 1.5, and it will again come back and end at 20.5. Next bar will start from 20.5 and end at 30.5, and its frequency density is 2.6. Starting at 20.5, we will go up to 2.6. So I can see here that suppose this value is 2.6, this is 2.4, so here you can have 2.6, and it will end at 30.5. Next we start at 30.5, will end at 40.5, and its height, you can say the frequency density is 2. Starting from 30.5, you will go up to 2. This is 2.1, so this is 2. 2, and go back till 40.5. And the last one, 40.5 to 50.5, you will go up to 1.6 frequency density. 40.5 to 50.5, your frequency density is 1.6. So basically, if you have drawn a histogram, now the area of each bar gives us frequency. This is the most important point. Area of this bar gives us frequency. Frequency of each interval. So they have asked us to find number of stores that are 35 kilometers or more. So from 40 kilometer to 50, my base is 10. 40.5 to 50.5, my base is 10. And what is my height? My height is over here 1.6. This is 1.6 height from here, you can see 1.6. So base is 10. Height is 1.6. Area of this rectangle is base into height 10 into 1.6, which is 16. So in this bar, your number of stores are 60. Now calculate number of stores in this bar. This bar was from 30.5 to 40.5. But I need to find number of stores from 35. This is 35, the middle value of 30.5 to 40.5. Now from 35 to 40, I have how much base? Base is 5. And my height up to here goes up to 2. My height goes up to 2. So this is 2. Lower than 2.1. So height is 2 and base is 5. So area of this region, that is 35 km to 40. Area of this one is base into height, 5 into 2 is 10. So total number of stores from 35 till 50, from 35 till 50 will be area of both these 10 plus 16, which is, what is this? So this is one of the way of solving this part. The last part is percentage of stores that 31 kilometers or more, from 31 or more. So from 31 or more, you have 20 plus 16, that is 36. Divided by total number of stores are 80, and to find percentage you need to multiply it with 100. On simplification, you will get 45%. Thank you so much.